Being an educator in Massachusetts is thrilling for me because we have some of the best education in the country. We lead the nation in K-12 education. We were the first state to offer free public school in Boston and the first state to offer free high school.
Standards-based learning means two things. Our lessons need to have certain content, the content that is described in the standards, and it also needs to give students the chance to practice scientific skills, such as analyzing data, designing investigations, and so on.
We believe every student should engage in scientific conversation using data every week. And I think it's important for our students to learn to be advocates for themselves and for their community. The open dialogue that we have in class allows them to learn those skills.
Hopefully by highlighting the use of data in these discussions, we'll really push teachers to think of ways to have students engage in actual investigations through data collection or accessing large data sets, which are just so authentic to what scientists are actually doing.
And an example of that in my classroom is using scientific literacy articles that include data from researchers who may be out in the field, from medical doctors who are recording information within their practice, or simply collecting their own data and analyzing that data using graphing skills and modeling skills that we're practicing every day within the classroom.
And what that looks like in technology and engineering is kind of connecting our classroom work to real world problems. So we can look at, well, you know, what are disabilities that people have, and how do engineers improve people's lives with disabilities?
I think it's important to look at the world around us and what's going on so that the learning is relevant. Data is really important for them to look at so that they can understand what's going on in the world today and make those important connections to real life.
It's not about what you remember. It's about the skills that you developed throughout the course of your K-12 education. I think we use the content as a vehicle now to teach the skill. And the skill is what's going to make them successful in college and career, whatever next steps they want to take.
At the end of the day, it's really around what they're getting, what the students are experiencing, and are they having a chance to learn about science and get excited by science and decide if that's something that they want to pursue post-secondary.
As their skills develop, they naturally fall into that mode of scientist and mode of learning science. And so I think that you find that the classroom is working cohesively, and you find that they're starting to ask scientific questions.
And it's really amazing to see how the students get engaged and inspired by what science can do and what science can teach them.
We are teaching the future. We want them to be successful, and I'm hoping that they change the world. I mean, they're gonna do some amazing things when it comes to science and engineering, and things that I could never have dreamed of.